Pinga pendekezo la ushuru kwa wamiliki wa magari likisema kuwa litaongeza maradufu ada za bima na kupunguza idadi ya watu watakaopata bima hizo. AKI inataka pendekezo hilo kuondolewa kabisa kwenye mswada wa fedha wa mwaka 2024, wakisema pia kuwa linaathiri biashara ya magari na kuwaweka wananchi kwenye hatari ya kukwepa kulipa bima. Hebu tusikize anayojiri.
And so the membership comprises of finance institutions such as DFIs, that's the Development Finance Institution, private equity, venture capital funds, impact funds, family offices, and intermediary advisory companies. The association represents approximately $3.0 billion in cumulative member funds under management. Our work is anchored on four pillars, and that's advocacy, training, intelligence, and events. Now, as we might be all aware that Kenya is the largest economy in East Africa and a prime destination definitely for private capital. Now, private capital comprised of private equity, venture capital, DFIs, local institution investors, and that's pension funds and asset managers, who channel substantial foreign direct investments into the Kenyan businesses. To give perspective on the investment figures likely to be affected, the following are East Africa investment statistics since 2013. We've seen PE deals, we've seen about 550 PE deals. We've also seen 1,000 VC deals within East Africa. And we've also seen PE investment at 5.1 billion. And so just to maybe give a bit of detailed information on how this looks like. PE investment cap is normally between $2 million to $20 million. And then we've seen VC investment at $5.5 billion. And the cap for VC investment is usually $100,000 to $5 million. Now, Kenya being a favorable and diverse ecosystem, majority of the PE deals then are usually in Kenya, and Kenya stands at 72% with $3.7 billion over the decade of 2013 to 2023, followed by Tanzania at $600 million and Ethiopia at $530 million. Now, looking at the economic benefits,